I was given a copy of Thomas Harris's brilliant thriller, Silence of the Lambs, long before it appeared in England or the film had been released. It was a present from the Appalachian crime writer Sharon McCrum, a sort of thank you for letting her base the seedy ex-academic tour guide murderer Rowan Rover in her Missing Susan on a recognizable caricature of my good self. But it was about Harris's other creation that Sharon wrote to me specifically. James Gumb, Buffalo Bill, the serial murderer who skins his humps. This was seen as a brilliant psychological study of a serial murderer, she told me. What did I think? I read the book and replied that while the work as a whole was a wonderfully tense thriller, with good and dense characterization by the standards of the genre, I didn't see Buffalo Bill as a profound psychological study. But I did see him as a criminal fascinatingly created from bits and pieces of other men's famous crimes. Ted Bundy's ploy for snaring victims. Chris Wilder's use of videos and non-pornographic television to turn himself on before starting to torture. Ed Kemper's adolescent approach to difficult grandparents. Leonard Lake's notion of adult playrooms. Oddly enough, Gumb's sophisticated stitchcraft and extravagantly camp queening pushed Ed Gein back into a minor place in my mind, just as Dr. Hannibal Lecter's beautifully realized good taste and cerebral superiority clouded all memories of America's best-known cannibal, Albert Fish. It was the snippety details from famous killers that caught the mind, rather than big general portraits. The obsessive recollection and glamorization of the mom who abandoned her infant son, suggesting Charles Manson. The deposit of a rare pupa as a signature in each victim's throat, culminating in the sinister death's head moth, recalling the Zodiac Killer's bizarre calling cards. Oh yes, Silence of the Lambs meant paying a lot of mental visits to a lot of old friends. I wonder whether you remember them all.